Hey, I'm Liz.
I'm Trevor.
And today we're going to be building an app to render our list of Rick and Morty characters and add them to our spaceship for a new adventure. We're going to do that using reactive variables.
Ooh. Reactive variables are a way to manage local state in our app with Apollo client.
This is our React app. Right now, we're making a GraphQL request to the Rick and Morty API to render out all of these different characters. We've got our spaceship at the top of the screen, but how do we get our passengers in there? Well, let's start by first giving each one of them a button to add them to the spaceship. I'm going to type out button tag and give it the label add to spaceship.
Next, we want to create our reactive variable. So in our client.js file, where our Apollo client instance is initialized, I'm going to import make var from Apollo client and then create a new variable called spaceship passengers var. This is going to be equal to us calling make var, and it's going to hold the IDs of the passengers in our spaceship. So just for testing purposes, I'm going to populate it with a few IDs right from the start.
Let's jump back over to our spaceship passengers component to see this reactive variable in action. First, let's bring in the reactive variable from our client.js folder. So we'll import spaceship passengers var from client. Next, we want to use the Apollo client utility use reactive var so that we can easily get this value printed out into our component. So we'll import use reactive var from Apollo client. Now we can create a new constant. We'll call this passengers and set it equal to calling use reactive var, passing in our reactive variable, spaceship passengers var. Next, let's just render out what the value of passengers is. See what we get in our UI. And we can see our dummy IDs of 1, 2, 3 printed out in our spaceship.
Now that our reactive variable is working, we want to use it to add a flag for every character in our app, telling us whether they are in our spaceship or not. And we can do this using a custom client-only field with type policies, a feature of the Apollo client cache that allows us to define for a given type, the character in this case, some custom fields. Our field is going to be called is spaceship passenger, and we can configure it using a read function. In our read function, we're going to destructure from the second argument a function called read field, which will allow us to grab the current character ID for any particular character. We'll say read field ID, and then this read function will return the value of spaceship passengers var, which can be retrieved by calling spaceship passengers var like a function. And we're going to say, does the spaceship passengers var include the current character ID? And that will give us a true or false value, depending on whether they are a spaceship passenger or not.
The cool thing about that custom field that we added is that we can actually use it now in any of our GraphQL queries. So jumping over to our character grid component, let's modify our getCharacters query to include that for each character. We're going to add the isSpaceshipPassenger field and actually denote it with a special flag at client. And that's going to tell Apollo client that this is a client only field that it can get by checking out that type policy that we added to our cache.
Then back in our character card component, we can change the text that shows up in the button depending on the value of character is spaceship passenger. If it's true, we'll say remove from spaceship. And otherwise, we'll say add to spaceship. And you notice that this won't have an effect on our app because we're still using dummy data in our reactive variable. But that will all change right after this word from our sponsor.
Our button text is updating dynamically based on whether each character is in our spaceship or not, but let's hook up some additional logic so that we can add them to the spaceship to begin with. First of all, we want to import our spaceship passengers var reactive variable from client.js. Down on our button component, we're going to define an onClick handler. And we'll paste in a function here and go through it line by line. The first thing that we're doing is calling spaceship passengers var as a function. And what this does is it returns the current value of this reactive variable into a constant that we're calling current passengers. So this is going to be the array of the IDs of the passengers who are currently in our spaceship. Next, we can set a new value for the spaceship passengers var by calling it as a function again, but passing in a new value. So the first thing that we're going to do is use that is spaceship passenger flag for each character to determine whether they're in the spaceship. If so, we're going to set a new value for current passengers by filtering out that character's idea so that we can bump them out of the spaceship. If they're not already in the spaceship, then what we're going to do is spread the current value of current passengers and then append our new character's ID on the back. This is going to add the character to our spaceship.
We can go back to the client.js file, clear out the dummy data that we created our reactive variable with originally, and we'll check out our app again and see that we can add characters to the spaceship and their IDs show up as spaceship passengers, and we can also remove them and boot them back out into space.
But I think we can do a little bit better than that. Let's bring in some additional data so we can show each passenger's image instead. Back in our spaceship passengers component, let's first bring in our utilities from Apollo client. We'll import useQuery and GQL. And then let's quickly paste in a nice query for our passengers. For each one of our characters, we're going to return their ID and image. And down in our component, let's go ahead and make use of this query. When we call getPassengers, passing it into useQuery, we'll get data loading an error back. Let's first handle our loading and error states in case anything goes wrong along the way. Now, down in our div, we can make some magic happen. For each one of our passengers in our spaceship passengers var, we want to pull out the ID and return the corresponding character information so that we can render our image in the UI. So we'll map over our characters and pull out each character ID. Let's create a constant called character to store each individual character. We'll first loop over data characters.results and find the corresponding character with the ID that matches each ID in our spaceship passengers var. Now, for each one of these characters, we'll return an image tag, setting a key for our character ID and setting a source of the character's image. And to make things look a little bit nicer, we'll just copy in some style rules. And let's jump back over to our UI to try it out. If we add Morty to our spaceship, if we add Beth and Rick, we can see that our spaceship is now rendering very clean images of each one of our passengers. And when we remove them, boop, they're booted out into space.
Woohoo! We did it! We've got a spaceship. High five, Liz!
Ha ha ha.